the kid that day you hate. The little black boy with no swag who wore his shoes without no lace. But now I'm getting P and getting famous. So you can keep your feet.
Now why walk when you can ride, mister? That mister went and got me.
Hand over what you got. Don't you ignore me, boy. I'll kill you.
Yeah! Mr. Marston, sir, John Marston. Mr. Marston, don't be so childish. Come on, sir, I implore you. Okay, so I made a few innocent mistakes when last we met. But my plan is still sound. Together we can conquer, if not the world, then certainly Bill Williamson.
But first, you need me to do you a favor?
You read my mind. I can only deduce you've been taking my tonic, sir, as instructed. It can give the most ordinary of intelligences a remarkable insight.
I'll give you insight. I'll show you what your guts look like.
Please, sir, this show of petulance is nothing short of embarrassing. Think for a moment, sir. Think.
I'm thinking about how much of my time you're wasting.
Sir. I am about to do something which I greatly discourage in all wise and rational men. A selfless act for you. But, sir, before I act selflessly, allow me to act selfishly and sell some of my wares.
Fair enough.
Oh, good, sir. Come, and let's go visit some of our fine friends in the other oil business we have here in Plainview. These men need all the help they can get.
Ladies and gentlemen, gather round, gather round. My friends, are you ready to change your lives forever?
Friends, hardworking souls of Plainview, do you suffer from rheumatism, lumbago, acute chronic sciatic, neurologic, or inflammatory pain? Well, I represent the only company that makes the genuine article which cures headache, neuralgia, toothache, earache, backache.
This man is a fucking charlatan. He just got done swindling us down at Cho Springs with this song and dance.
I say we tar and feather him right now.
I say we shoot the bastard.
I think it's time we take our business elsewhere. I apologize if science is not your forte. Good day, one and all.
You want to stop doing that?
Let's go, my boy. I think we've outstayed our welcome.
Come on, John! I'm not waiting! You're my trouble! For Christ's sake, John, get on the damn wagon! worry about.
Expansion of your West Dickens elixir might have come dropping.
Nonsense. Just another bump on science's rocky road. Good God! There's more of them! Good shot! Look to the front, John! Here we go again! Yes! We got him! It sure is lucky you came along.
Lucky for you! Promising them.
Come on, nobody needs to die over this.
For a man of the people, you sure ain't very popular.
I am up against the weight of plebeian ignorance, my boy.
Change of career.
I will never give up on science, John. Just calm down, will you? John, there's Cueva Seca up ahead.
Hey,
That was a little hairy. Thank you, my dear boy. You saved the day again.
It always impresses me with the speed with which a group of men can turn from passive sheep into murderous wolves.
I'm impressed with how you nearly got us killed back there.
Well, yes, perhaps we should shelve the tonics business for a period.
Let's say we try our hand at racing again. There's a meet at Rathskeller.
You're trying my patience, Mr. West Dickens.
Well, I'm sorry, dear boy, but I'm only an aging vendor of exotic elixirs, not the bloody U.S. Cavalry. And forgive me if matters take some time to prepare.
How do you do?
That's a mighty fine course that you got there, young lady. I thought you let hungry Irish and tied and drink. But where are you? Oh, who do you want? I see you. Get away from me.
Right here. Where's that machine gun, Irish?
Oh, Mr. Marston. I found you one.
Found us one, Irish. We're in this together. You, me, and an assault on Fort Mercer. I'm the guy that saved you from getting killed back there, and who you owe your life to, remember?
Not really. Happens to me all the time.
You don't want it to happen to you again, do you, Irish?
No, friend. I wants to buy you a drink. I wants to tell you how much you means to me, how special you is.
And I want to tell you that if you don't produce a Gatling gun within the hour, you'll wish you'd been killed back there.
It's the whiskey, sir. It gives me the memory of a newborn babe, as innocent as can be.
And it makes me violently angry. Shall we go look for that gun, sir?
Yes. Let's do that.
Come on, then. We'll find your precious gun. Gia!
Come on!
Oy, lovely faithless Flora, the lily of the west.
You're not gonna pass out on me, are you, Irish?
Me? No, I'm right as rain. or at least somewhere stuck between fair and meddling.
Well, you're gonna be stuck somewhere between dying and dead if you try to cross me again.
It weren't like that at all, feller. My intentions were pure. I swear it on me poor mother's life. I just gets a tad confused from time to time. Honest mistake.
If there's any more confusion, I'll finish what your friends in Armadillo started.
Jesus! You're an impatient bastard, aren't you?
Where's the gun, Irish?
I hear some miners been blabbing about a machine gun they found. Apparently, they got it stashed up at Gaptooth Breach.
What do miners want with a machine gun?
Shoot it at somebody, I suppose. Or sell it. I don't know. Never been down a mine in all my life.
Sounds real fishy to me, Irish. I've just about had it with you and your gangs. You and Wes Dickens are so crooked, you can swallow nails and spit out corkscrews.
Maybe if you was more cordial with folks, they might be better inclined to help you.
I saved your life and you repaid me by lying, nearly getting me killed.
Not far now, Johnny. We should go around the side of Gaptooth so the miners don't see us coming.
I still don't know what miners would want with a machine gun.
Miners are always fighty bastards. Spend too long without daylight and doxies, and it starts playing with your mind.
I never heard so much shit come out of one mouth.
Only telling you what I heard. Oh, and we'll need a wagon or something to get it out of there. That gun's heavier than sin.
So how was I supposed to move it by myself last time? You two-faced little bastard.
Here we are. Let's stop here a moment to get a lie of the land.
Stop, damn it!
The entrance is plain to see, and there's a shaft them bastards use to haul out heavy ore. We, I mean you, can use that lift to get you and the gun to the surface. I do it all myself, but the mines play havoc with me sinuses. I'll find us a fine place to hide these horses, and then return with a borrowed flat wagon.
I'll meet you at the mouth of the mine shaft, and Irish, I strongly advise you don't run off this time.
You're trespassing. State your business or move along.
You can still run away!
Troublemaker!
Walk away!
Oh, pink and straight. You ain't ready for me. We got a belter right here!
What have we got here?
Don't let him get to the gun! You won't be above snakes for long, you son of a bitch!
Don't try to be something you're not!
I'm gonna keep plugging till I hit pay dirt. Better duck!
your gun down, Fred!
Excuse me, mister.
God damn it!
Annoying, prick!
You must have a real bad death wish!
If it ain't me, it's someone else. What can I say, partner?
I'm gonna learn. You. I'm
running for cover.
Avatar!
I hope you got money for a funeral.
Killed me when you had the chance.
I'd be looking at your corpse being hauled up this lift. Load up and I'll engage the gears. there she is. What a beautiful weapon. God's own gun. Ain't that the truth? I got us a borrowed flatbed parked down below. Don't let go of her. She's a beast.
You ain't gonna win this. They surely know where I am. Let's go!
A short wee ride now, and we'll have this executive peacemaker delivered to Old West Dickens.
Just make sure it doesn't fall off on the way.
Mr. West Dickens.
Ah, Mr. Marston. How wonderful to see you, sir. How wonderful.
Are we ready, then?
Yes, sir. Nearly, sir. Barely nearly, sir. I just need some cash to get some extra hardware fitted to my old Trojan horse here.
You what?
Never mind, sir. I can only presume that you have not enjoyed the benefits of a classical education, so I will not take umbrage if some of my illusions sail over your head, sir.
I won't pretend to understand you, but I will endeavor to make you understand me. Either we do this right now, or I put a bullet in you and get on with my day.
Please, I knew you were a violent man, Mr. Marston, but I did not think you were a stupid one. We need money to outfit my carriage, to turn a simple tradesman's vehicle into something more subterfuge. And I'm about to tell you how we are going to gain said cash. Now I know that you ride very well. So come, sir, to Rathskeller Fork.
Follow me, John. It's not too far to Rathskeller Fork. So how are you, John?
Okay, all things considered. Hopefully we can get through today without running into another army of your satisfied customers.
Onwards and upwards! I refuse to let the blind stupidity of the proletariat derail my calling in life.
Nothing blind about it. I'd say they saw right through you.
Ah, before knowledge comes doubt, my dear boy.
Everybody knows you're as crooked as a dog's hind leg, Wes Dickens.
I resent that implication, John.
I wasn't implying. I was telling. You're such a successful businessman. What are you doing living in a cave?
Delightfully Dickensian, isn't it?
If you say so.
Are you familiar with the concept of philanthropy, John?
I'm surprised you are.
Oh, I don't do any of this for myself, John. I hope you realize that. It's been quite a ride, John, hasn't it?
We haven't gone that far.
No, I mean us. Ridgewood Farm, Gaptooth Breach, Plainview. We make quite a team, you and me. Brains and brawn. We should consider a more permanent partnership.
This partnership ends as soon as I have Bill Williamson. I appreciate your help, but I've just about had it with all your schemes. You need to realize what's at stake here.
I know, John, I know. Just win this race and we'll be ready. I give you my word. There it is, John. Rathskeller Port.
Hi there.
You can't beat a good horse race.
Gentlemen, this will be a fair race. No shooting, stabbing, cliff pushing, rock throwing, cactus grinding, neck lassoing, setting fires, or other acts that causes a rider to unfairly lose his weight or bleed heavily or black out. Get yourselves ready. Set. Go!
He came, he saw, he conquered. What a fantastic spectacle, John. Let's take a moment to bask in the glory of our victory.
Have we got enough money now?
All right. Yes, once Seth and Irish have furnished their side of the bargain, I think we should be ready. Quite a team we've assembled, don't you think?
A bunco, a grave robber, and a drunk. How could things possibly go wrong?
Get beat, huh?
This steed looks right tetchy, I don't mind telling. Good luck, son. He's a wild one, and no mistake.
Come on now! Easy!
Hello, Matt Contrast.
out here. I could really use a ride. Actually, I got a better idea. See you around, fool.
You think I won't find you? Sorry, must have slipped. Come on.
Up, sister. Put them up.
Irish, what are you doing?
Who the hell are you?
Give me that. I'm your old friend Amnesia.
Oh, good blimey.
And I've come to tell you, if you ever pretend to forget my name or your debt to me again, I'll make sure you reach heaven before these two ladies. Now get down there.
Oh, Mr. Marston. How are you?
Ashamed. Ashamed to know you. What the hell's wrong with you, robbing these gentlewomen and ladies of the Lord?
I thought they was doxies.
Ladies, I'm sorry about this man. He's unfortunately lost his mind to the demon drink. At least I hope he has, and he wasn't this stupid all along. So, please excuse us. Now, Irish, that Gatling gun doesn't work. I find that rather upsetting, don't you?
Oh, heartbreaking. Which is why I was just coming to see you when the drink got the better of me. Come on. I know where we can find the parts for you. Motherfucking Mary.
How about a drink or two, mister?
I don't think my dear wife would appreciate that too much.
What you looking at? What you looking at? Huh?
I can't stand to see a man walk around with such a dry pecker. Can I help?
Drunk as I am, my prick's in fine working order.
What a lusty specimen you are. I like that.
That fresh air's got me head spinning like a top. Can't be good for a fella.
Shut up, you lazy drunk. Before I stop your head spinning with a bullet.
I resent that, Johnny. I've been working like a beaver on your behalf.
You've been working like a weasel on my behalf. Bushwhacking defenseless ladies of the cloth? You must have been raised on sour milk, Irish.
What are you talking about? I'm a good Catholic boy.
You're a booze-blind coward.
And you're a hypocrite, Marston. You've robbed just as many innocent folks as me.
I tried to only rob those who had more than they deserved.
Christ, the church has more
Dude,
money
friend,
than anybody.
Don't go getting all severe.
Where are we going, Irish? Bus?
Just to the warehouse here in Thieves Landing. I'm telling you, Johnny boy, it's
friend,
all set up. We're
room.
Meeting this pal of mine at the back door of the office. Hobble-tongued feller by the name of Shaky.
And he's got the ammunition we need?
Jesus, stop fretting, will you? I knows about guns front, back, and sideways.
You're gonna be real familiar with mine if things keep on this way.
All right, we're here. Stay close. Well, I'll be buggered. This door was supposed to be unlocked.
Oh, well, we'll go around the back. Shaky's probably waiting for us there.
I'm starting to think you're soft on me, Johnny boy. Can't even sneeze these days without you being there to catch the drips.
This is your last chance, you good-for-nothing shyster. You've already wasted too much of my time.
Keep your eyes open. Shaky's all right, but I don't trust the gang of fools he runs with.
Shaky's made the arrangements, and he'll...
Oh, shite.
Sounds like Shaky's only gone and got himself found out.
All right. Now all we have to do is find out who you work with.
You hear me?
Shaky, you wretched fucking son of a whore. Suck my again!
Oh! Labor relations don't sound like they're exactly at an all-time high. You sneak in and get poor Shaky loose. I'll go get the wagon. Good luck, Marston. He's a good man, that Shaky.
Again!
I'll be waiting out by the front gate with the wagon. Good luck.
Thank you for your kindness, mister. I thought I was dead, man.
My kindness is only as good as the bullets you can fetch up for me and your friend Irish. Let me down, and you'll be a dead man.
This is gonna be one hell of a fight. All right, let's get out of here while we got the chance.
That's too damn close!
I'll kill all you bastards!
No, you don't!
It's where it is, buddy!
I'll see your
butt right here!
Right. I'm gonna kill you and rob you! Let's head for the door. Follow me. Come on, you little bastard! Who's next? Shit, nail! Let's shoot the hell out of these cowards!
You made your last mistake!
Oh, no!
That's some awful dainty hand you got there.
Nobody puts their hands on!
You know you're gonna die, right?
Come on, partner! Let's finish these sons of bitches! All right, let's get out of here while we got a chance! Open the door! I got you covered!
What have you got for me? Can I borrow this, friend?
Get your thumb out of your nose and get
over. Come on,
goodbye, gentlemen.
Now we're even.
Half even, Shaky. You still owe me for them morphine pills to calm your nerves. Shaky.
You'll get your half. More, you dirty fucking snake.
All right, gentlemen. Let's go.
Fucking fuck.
Oh, my virgin ears.
Come on, then, Johnny boy. Let's go. Did you have fun in there, you and Shaky?
I killed a lot of men for this damn machine gun of yours.
I'm sorry I missed all the dramas.
You always miss all the drama. There must be cobwebs growing on that holster of yours.
Someone's got to drive the wagon, don't they? Teamwork, Johnny boy. That's my game, not just the glory like you. Right, hop on. I'll get us out of here.
It's never easy with you, is it?
There's a reason this place is called Thieves Landing.
Good thing I had Shaky with me. I don't think I'd have made it out by myself.
He's a funny little bastard. It's always raining when you're talking to Shaky, that's for sure. Drinks like a warrior, though. He's a good pal of mine, that lad.
None of your friends seem to like you very much.
Jealousy. You need to man up, because... You're gonna run out of bullets if you keep on like that. Christ! They're coming after us! Hold them off, Johnny. I'll get you back to the Carlin.
I've dropped 100 fools like you!
Jesus, we really ruffled a few feathers back there.
What? Seems like half the new Austin boys we did.
Thanks, Deloy! How many are there? I don't know if I can take much more of this! They're shooting right at me!
You're a real cold-blooded killer, Irish.
I don't like this, Marston. My heart's beating like a bloody drum.
Just drive, Irish. You're acting like a schoolgirl.
Get that fella on the bridge!
Anytime you want to shoot somebody, Irish, please feel free.
They're not giving up, are they?
Christ, that was close!
Here come more of them bastards!
You starting to regret this yet? I'm telling you, Irish.
What the hell? Well, I think you're ready for part, Mercer. You got enough ammunition here to take down a small country, fella.
I'm gonna need it. Bill Williamson's got himself an army.
So I guess this is where we part ways, Johnny Marston.
Or maybe not, friend. You're gonna be right alongside me when I take on that fort. After all you put me through, it's time you pull the damn trigger for once. Show me what a big, bad killer you really are.
Yes, of course. What am I thinking? Don't worry, you can count on me. I just hope I don't steal all your glory. Wouldn't be right or proper. Hell of a team, me and you. We should consider making this a more permanent partnership.
I think I've about had my fill of liars in this life, partner.
Impressive, Marston. We'll have West Dickens's wagon rigged and ready to go soon enough.